Okay, so happy Sunday. This is going to be a very casual live stream. It's not planned at all, so I am going to add a work to a Hi Birdie. So I'm going to add a work to this traveling sketchbook that I got. This travel all the way to Russia and then to Victoria, BC. So this is some of the work that they have put it in, which is great. So I think this is the original owner's work. This is to another person, very beautiful urban sketch. And this is Alina. I think she is in Victoria, BC, so yeah, you can see that, right? Victoria, BC. Let me see if I can get that. Yeah, Chinatown, Victoria, BC. And then, so it's my turn. So I'm not good with urban sketch with pen and ink and watercolor. So I did a portrait last weekend. So I'm going to do maybe a scenery this week. And I'll do a horizontal orientation. It's really slim, so it's either really good for like really tall buildings, scenery like these, or a kind of long landscape. So I'll try that. So the reference image is right up there. So a couple things that I need to work with is that I don't know how well this paper is going to take the water. Sorry, got a sip of coffee. So last week when I did this portrait, it's holding it okay, but I didn't do very huge big wash, so some wet on wet and stuff, as you can see. I actually really like how this one turns out, actually. Look at that cat, the mean looking cat. Okay, so yeah, but most of this couple hard edges and stuff, few wet on wet and some softening, but it's not a lot of wet on to wet wash. So I'm probably not going to do too much wet on wet work. Anyways, enough talk, let's draw a line drawing first. So this is very, very casual, so don't mind me, okay? So very small paper. Look at my hand is bigger than the paper. So this street scenery, I took it last week when I was out for a walk in Kirkland, Washington. So people can start going out for a walk and stuff, even though we didn't stay out for that long. Still not feeling super safe right now. Anyway, so this is going to be very, very simple. Okay, the paper is really small, so it's not meant for a big, complicated scenery with a lot of details. So, okay. That doesn't mean that we start to be very careless and stuff. Okay, so a bunch of neatly trimmed bushes and stuff. There's actually a rock wall behind this. Okay, so there's so many of this, structures for the fence. I'm just going to roughly block those in. Okay, so here we go. So you guys are feel free to ask me anything or just talk whatever you want. Okay, so here's a, let me see. It's a card right here, so which is a nice foreground element, so I'm probably gonna keep that. And then I'll probably do like a cast shadow. Yeah, I'll probably do like a cast shadow all the way here. So even though there's no cast shadow, no foreground cast shadow in the reference photo, I think to get that in will be better, just so that we can have a little bit more connection. Okay, so bunch of connection here, and let's have one car move forward just a little bit. What time is it? It is 1:30 Pacific Standard Time, I mean Seattle time. Okay, let's see if I can, yeah. So let's make a car that's a little bit closer. A little bit lower, not as high as the horizon. So here is, just going to draw a beamer. Careful with the foreshortening, okay? We only see a little bit of the side. Okay, one of the common problem I see when people are drawing cars or painting cars, they make the side a little bit too long and it doesn't look right. It looks like a limousine. Because of the foreshortening, we don't see a lot of the side, just a little bit. And the closer it is to the vanishing point, the lesser we're going to see. Okay, so a couple cars. So most of it, we're just going to simplify into some very simple shape, you know, visual languages and stuff. So in case you haven't watched my latest video on visual language, go watch that. I worked pretty hard on that one. Anyways. Okay, so I'm wondering if I should paint a figure in there, but it's so small. I don't know if I want to do that. Yeah, we'll just, maybe just something very simple. I'll make it a little bit taller though. Okay. Maybe just like a couple walking or something. Okay, the curb side right here. Okay, so let's go in a little bit. Oh, 4:30 p.m. I saw it's like resolution is 4:30 p.m. It's like, no, that's not good. Sorry. The tech world we're living right now, I automatically think about the resolution. Okay, so let's just give a little bit more love on the house here, which is, you know, the big major shape here. Okay, so here we... Okay, so it's another one. So this part is probably mostly going to be in the shadow. There's like a balcony and stuff. There's a plastic wrap around it. I don't know why. Maybe some construction going on. We're just going to ignore that. And there's a side structure here. So these two going to be, you know, some nice highlight there. Okay, let's lower the fence just a little bit. It looks a little bit too tall there. Okay, so I'll treat it as plein air. Old school here. No worries, it's me. Maybe just like a habit of a YouTuber, just think about resolution all the time. Okay, so there's a little lamppost. I think it's kind of nice breaking out from all this tree shape. Okay, so I think this is good enough for us to start painting. Sorry. So again, I'm not good with ink and watercolor paint. I mean, I can do an ink. I actually don't have a pen. But yeah, I think I'll just keep doing what I'm a little bit more comfortable with. That being said, this is a very small painting, so hopefully we don't need to spend too much time on it. So we'll do the sky first. The sky, you know, there's some clouds and stuff, but we don't really have a lot of space for a big sky too, so I'll just maybe pre-wet some of the areas here. And again, I don't know how well the wet-on-wet is going to work for this painting, so mostly just going to do a little bit of test. I can reuse this. It's a nice warm tone that I can use that for the house, definitely. So yeah, I can just get that right in here. So again, the first wash, just get the color of the light in, okay? Don't worry about, you know, don't stress out about leaving white and stuff. At least for something this small, it's just not worth to stress yourself over it. Okay, get that. Some nice warm light on the building. And then I think we can go ahead and put some sky color in, cobalt blue. I want to warm it up a little bit, so I'm going to grab the cerulean blue from Mission. Some people say it looks more like phthalo blue. I don't know. I never used phthalo blue before, at least from other brand. So I am not quite sure, but it is a beautiful blue. So yeah, I have to press the paper because the paper buckles like crazy. So I kind of have to work with that. I can probably tape it down somehow, but not sure it's necessary for what this is going to be. Okay, so a little bit of softening. I do want to leave a little bit hard edge there. So some shadow. I don't know. I actually don't know what paper is this. I think it's like Fabriano and 50% cotton or something like that. I painted last week. I painted a portrait with it last week. I actually like it. I might try to find out and, you know, buy a few and test things out. But yeah, I'm actually not quite sure what this paper is. I apologize. Okay, just get some paint in here. Again, don't worry about leaving white. This is so small, it doesn't really matter. I just paint some color of the light in. It looks like it's drying pretty rapidly. We can mix some green colors, some warm green. So cobalt turquoise, Hansa yellow. Yeah, a little bit more Hansa yellow. Yeah, get that nice warm green here. Okay. So I'll leave a little bit of highlight for the figure, but yeah, just very simple. Okay, so here's some more light green here and a bunch of bushes down here. Okay, I'll leave a little bit of white on the top of the car. Okay. Some green here. There's some green back here. It's mostly going to be covered up with darker green, so it doesn't really matter. Okay, doesn't matter. I'm gonna paint a happy face here just to tell you that it doesn't matter. Okay, I have a plan, so this shouldn't matter that much. Maybe I should just leave that happy face there. Like, hi, sorry, I'm painting, so I'm not looking at the chat that much. But thank you for being here. I wasn't planning to do a live stream this weekend, but since I'm going to paint this, I thought, well, maybe I'll just do a very casual one just for fun. And it's like a real, real nice little sketch. I think this will be fine. Okay, so I'm just grabbing whatever dirty color is it here. One of the question I've been asked is like, how do I not mix muddy color? And look how much mud I'm using. A lot of time it doesn't really matter what color you use, it's the way you apply the paint. Okay, if you keep scrubbing it, if you keep trying to dab it like these, and if you keep trying to disturb the wash, then it's going to turn dirty. And especially later on, if you do like a second or third wash, if you still paint with very transparent layer, everything underneath is going to show through and it's going to become a dirty color. Not dirty color, it's just going to show every single stuff brushstroke underneath. So that's going to cause a problem. So most of the time when people say how do I avoid muddy color, what they really need to work on is to keep their wash clean. And that is something I struggle with as well when I just get started. I paint too much detail. I mean, I try to do too much in a wash. So that this happened. Okay, I'm going to just a couple simple brushstroke for the car. Again, this is a very small paper, so I need to scale my detail accordingly. Okay, I don't have space for every single car with four wheels and stuff. That's not really a smart way to go. Okay, so, and this is like just like the first wash. I do paint a little bit more thicker. I do paint a little bit thicker just because I don't want to paint too many layers on this sketchbook. Graphite watercolor pencil. I never tried that. Actually, I just use pencil for line drawing and then paint on top. As typical as it. Okay, so I'm just gonna wait for it to dry. I mean, I already talked about the story of the sketchbook a little bit earlier when I start, but I can talk about it again since we're waiting for this to dry. So, well, I share my work on Instagram, and one of the girls, she is also a watercolor artist. She's from Victoria, BC. And she contacted me saying she's doing this traveling sketchbook with her friend. So the sketchbook is her friend from Russia. Okay, as you can probably, I don't know, I can't read Russia, so there you go. B Beautiful writing though. Okay, my handwriting is really ugly. Look at that, that's my handwriting. It looks like a grade school kid. Okay, older your handwriting is better than me. So that's the translation, my friend. I think she's also Russian. So she translate this message. So my humble translation, travel is like a shorter version of life. Let this sketchbook reflect not one, but many lives. Wish you inspiration, lucky, happiness, and peace. Sorry, Russian language is weird to translate from. I don't know. Sounds beautiful to me. Okay, so, and then, you know, they've been sharing their work. So this is the original girl who, let me hide my face, the original girl whose work, and then that's also, I don't know the name, I apologize. I'm not gonna try to sabotage the name, okay. And then, this is the second person, okay. Let me zoom it out a little bit so you can see better. Okay, so that's the full view of the second person sketch. Really nice, really big. And then this is my friend, the one who asked if I want to participate this. So that's her urban sketch. This is Victoria. This is also Victoria. She says Chinatown in Victoria, BC. I love Victoria, by the way. Like the first place I want to visit after this whole stay at home ordeal is probably Victoria or Vancouver. And then last week I saw, well, there's a lot of nice scenery, so let me change a pace and do a portrait. So this is my portrait. This is Heloise, I think. Yeah, she's a very young, talented harp musician that I follow on Instagram. So she shared her kind of afternoon tea time with her cat on her leg. So I saw it's a nice little moment to do a sketch on. So I just do that sketch there. So not going to keep any of these. I'll keep the digital copy, but this is probably going to send it to the next person, which I'm still deciding. Okay, so I think this is dry enough for me to work on the second wash. Now the second wash will be, before I do that, let me take a sip of water. There's some kids screaming, but I don't think it's my kid. Anyways, okay, so let me use a perla this time. So the second wash, there's some kids screaming outside, I apologize. Well, not really. Happy kids, it's nice. Okay, so the second wash, so I've kind of squinted your eyes on the reference photo, which is even easier for you because it's really small. You kind of see all the house and the tree, even the light part of the tree kind of merges together. So we'll do that. We'll paint it as a one shape, one single shape. So let me mix the color first. So burnt umber and some cobalt blue. Get that neutral gray. This is my default gray, burnt umber and cobalt blue. These two together is a very neutral gray. Okay, now for the house, we have a little bit red tone to it, and a little bit orange here. Okay, so we got, but we still need to darken that a little bit more blue. I'll add some ultramarine here. Okay, so I'm mixing color while I'm thinking about how do I approach this. I have a pretty good idea, but still getting a little bit. And tree, so cobalt turquoise. I'll add some burnt umber, make it darker. A little bit burnt sienna too. Okay. Wash my brush. Get it on the cloth a little bit. Okay, I think we are good to go. So I'm going to start with the... Hi from St. Louis, hi. Okay, I'll start from the edge of the house here. So, oh, I forgot to paint the light side. Oops. Should have painted that first. Well, that's fine. I mean, we can do that a little bit later with a glaze. Okay, so let me actually make it just a little bit darker. Okay. Hello from Oregon. Okay, so, you know, just a little bit, use a tip, okay? And let's get that chimney in. Okay, very simple, okay? Don't overdo it. Chimney, and then let's do our house. Let's do our roof here. So this is a second wash. We will do a third wash. Okay, so if in any case we need to paint a darker shadow, we can do that. Okay, oops, a little bit too blue. To mix my color a little bit better. But actually it's fine. I actually like to have a little bit more interesting color. Okay, so this look quite dark, but I do think, actually, let me put a paper underneath. I don't want to ruin the paper. I don't want to ruin the painting underneath, so. Okay. So here we got this. Okay. I'm actually just paint the light side of the building in. See, it's quite wet. It's quite wet. You can see the bead here. Okay, so let me just bring this down. Otherwise, that bead is going to make this a cauliflower edges. So might as well just wet the whole thing. So it's not going to happen. That's a trick I kind of figure out as I'm learning watercolor. Like if you have a bead coming down, or you know that some water is going to seep back in, then just, you know, wet the whole area to keep their wetness even. Okay, so there we go. Oops. So this is Kirkland. If you wonder where this is Kirkland in Washington. Ever wonder why the Costco brand name Kirkland? Because yeah, that's where it's coming from. I think. Okay, so the roof, we just paint it as one single shape. Okay, so I'm leaving out the light part there. Okay, so now you might wondering, why do I paint the roof all the same value? Because there's some part of the roof that is lit by the sun. While that is true, the overall value of the roof is a lot darker. So don't be tricked just because you have the perception that it is lit by the sun, therefore it must be light. Not always true. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Now I will connect this to some of the foliage. Let me actually change a brush for that. Change to a small Kulinski brush. Sorry, some kids outside. Having fun. Sunday afternoon. That's why I usually like to do live stream later, because there's less noise from the neighbor in my own house. But this is a casual one, so bear with the noise. Okay, so connect that. Okay, so I can start to get some tree colors in. Cobalt turquoise, burnt umber. You don't need a lot of color to mix a nice earthy toned green. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna darken this tree just a little bit. This is, you know, this is part of the house shape, okay? Just because you see some lighter green doesn't mean everything is really bright, okay? That's something we need to kind of watch out for. Focus on overall value and shape. Okay, so let's go back to the building. A lot of form going on there. I don't know if you're talking about a painting, but that's what, you know, that's our, what our job is. We try to simplify as much as possible. Plus, this is a small sketch. I'm really not looking to get a really big, sophisticated painting here. Okay. So just treat this as a one single shape. Okay, I'll leave a little bit of the highlight for the fence and the side of the house here where it's catching some sunlight. Okay, but the rest of it is just one single shape. Okay, so don't get trapped into all the details. Okay, get the big shape in and you should be good to go. Okay, the roof, just a bunch of complicated shape. I'm just getting the general shape of it. And you can connect them all together. Doesn't really matter. It's about a whole picture. There we go. Okay. Now we got the house and we got some lighting. Okay, that's pretty good. Now can continue the foliage. I'll add a little bit ultramarine blue, make it a little bit cooler. Alberta, is it still really cold there? I have a friend who lives in Calgary. I mean, I haven't visited Alberta much. I mean, the closest I've been to is Banff, which is an amazingly beautiful place in Canada. I went to Lake Louise and, you know, some of the glaciers there just, this is amazingly beautiful. Hi from Italy, hope you are well. Okay, so look at the foliage, just keep it, keep this nice and loose, okay? Just let the brush do the work. Okay, and here. So I'm not gonna paint everything. I do want to leave a little bit of the, you know, the warm light there. So bang, 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 bang. Okay, I think that's good. Use the texture of the paper. Don't dab. Oh, okay, I see 100 leaves, so let me do that. No, okay, just use the paper. This is probably, I don't know, it's cold press or rough, so there's some texture. And I have a soft brush, so just very quickly, just do that. Swirl a little bit and just let the brush do the work for you. If you really want to paint super detailed, this is not the paper. This is not the format and size for you, or anyways. It's so small, that's why. And I already paint very slow, so if I keep dabbing details, we're gonna be here all night, all day and all night, and we don't want to do that. So here we go. So there's a building there. Hi from Hawaii. Oh, I miss Hawaii so much. Okay, so there's a building here, but this just merge with the tree. Okay, it's just like that. Fine. It's almost on the edge anyways. Doesn't really matter. Okay, so just let me make some blue color and something a little bit different from the foliage, and just continue that wash down. Okay. Leaving a little bit of the random highlight. Sorry, I need to keep moving the zoom camera because this paper is really small. Okay. Here, some couple random highlights, and that suggests detail. Stuff in the horizon. There's a little dots or whatever. Cars, people, doesn't matter. It's really that small. See, look at my finger. That's how small this area is. How are you doing today? I am very good. Thank you. Okay, so I think I need to move the paper to the left just a little bit. There we go. A lot better. We have an overall nice shape going on. Okay, so let me continue this shape to the car, and we are like 80% there. Okay, so we got a bunch of fence, so I'm just gonna do this. Bang, 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 bang. Okay, here we go. We got the fence. Let's move on. Repetitive shapes are a trap to me. It's like, yeah, you'd want to get them all in, and you want to get them all nicely painted and stuff. So it's very easy that we start to want to do all this. It's just not necessary. Okay. Okay. I feel like I'm already starting to paint the third layer. That's fine. We can do that. Okay, a little bit of foliage and tree. Now let's stop stalling and start to do the car. Cars are easy since we already got the drawing down. Okay, back to my neutral tint. We have snowstorm here. Oh my goodness. Okay, so let's start from our main car. So it's almost in the middle of the page, which usually is a big no-no for composition, but I think this one is fine. I'm I'm treating this like a sketch anyways, so you know, it doesn't matter. So we just connect that dark tree shape into the car windshield. Okay, and then the front of the car, front grille, there. And that to the bottom of the bumper. And got a little hint of the shadow for the wheel here. Little side view mirror, side window. And I think we are good. Now, while we're at it, we can paint the shadow of the car while it is still wet so I can connect them together. Very sunny and warm. I am so glad. We had some really hot days about like 2 weeks ago, and all of a sudden the temperature dropped back. So now it's kind of chilly again. But we got more sunny days than rainy day now. So much for a rainy Seattle. It's almost summer, so yeah, this year has been weird. I know most of us are spending time indoors, so the season just kind of went by. Okay, so I'm snucking in a little suggestion of a car here. Okay, so here, you know, a couple details here. Here's a windshield, and we're done. Okay, there's another car here. That's the windshield, and we're done. Okay, don't fuss too much with it. Okay, little wheel down here and the one back there. It's not even worse. Work on it. And if you work every single car just into the same degree as the one in the front, that's only going to make it flat. Okay, you need to have a little bit contrast in terms of the detail as well. Okay. Excuse me. So let's put the foreground stuff in. So I have this, the background trees, and I'll somewhat connect to this car in the front. Okay. Let me just treat it as one single shape, okay? Even though you see windshield, license plate and all that stuff is all in the dark. That's not even fuzz with it. Okay. I really enjoy this sketchbook. I like the idea that we kind of share our work, and I actually don't know where the sketchbook is gonna end up. Maybe back to the owner, but it's kind of nice to do a little contribution, and I'm not gonna keep this work, so at the end feels like a gift. It's also a little bit of pressure because you don't want to ruin the work that people has been putting in. But at the same time, not like, you know, trying to show off or anything. Just like it's a fun little activity. And it's amazing in the, you know, in the day of age of internet, we get to meet and make friend with, you know, different people with watercolor. There we go. That shadow just kind of encompassed the shape, give it a nice frame. Okay, so you know, we got this nice shape from this house to the middle ground, the background, and then connect to the car, and then it leads you back into it. So, you know, it's kind of like a complete picture here. So big shape, very, very important. Okay, let's work on our tiny little figure. I kind of a little bit regret putting figures in. looks so nice now. If I paint the figure, it might just, like, ruin the whole thing. So let's just keep them very, very simple. Very, very simple. Okay, so got an accidental stroke on it. Doesn't matter. Okay. So, you know, the head. And the head and neck. Okay, don't just put a dot and leave it. Okay, so I'll just make them wear, let's just wear like a white shirt or whatever. Something very simple. Okay, and this person wearing kind of like a turquoise color. And let's do it dark. Maybe a jean or something. Connect them. It's fine. Okay, so that looks okay. And then I'll paint their shadow as well. So their shadow from their feet to the side, maybe a little bit up because they cast some shadow on the those grass, those bushes. There's some stone wall here, so I'm just gonna paint that in too. Okay, and the accidental stroke is gone. Okay, let me cut this highlight in a little bit. There we go, nice. It's a nice sunlit scenery. I probably need to do a glaze to make the road a little bit darker. I'm still debating on that though. Before that, let's paint a little bit of the signal here. Well, not signal, street light. What am I talking about here? Just very, very simple. Okay. Just a little bit of... Okay. Just something to kind of break that tree lines. Okay, a little bit too much light here. Let me... So we're almost done. So right now what I'm doing is to see what I can add that will enhance the picture. So in this case, if I do this right here, if I add some darker tree here, that's gonna pop this right out. Just to get that nice light going on. Okay, and then some tiny little details here and there on the house. Like this feels a little bit too bare, but you know, just... So, just a little suggestion. Something like this, I think that's more than enough. Okay. This windows needs to be painted over. Thank you, Jeff. Thank you so much. You're like my big supporter. I really appreciate that. Okay, so let's add some dark details. So this is just to, like, I like how this is looking, so I'm not going to add much detail here. Okay, so, but this chimney casting a shadow on the roof, so I'm just paying to paint that in. There's some little details on the roof here, so I don't know, I'm just gonna suggest something without actually painting much. Okay. Little structure here for the chimneys and whatever. And I'm just gonna use neutral tint. Okay. Some little detail underneath the roof. Okay, this part I actually like it as a one shape, so I'm not going to fuss with it. Okay, so the figures, seeing they're dry enough, I'm just gonna snug in a little bit of hair on top. Okay, so maybe this one is a female or whatever, just so that I can. Excuse me. Okay, so the curbs, I'm just gonna add a little bit of the red line here so cars cannot park there. Well, it ends here, so that's why that car is parking there. Okay, I don't want to mess that up, or people spot is gonna be like, hey, this people needs to get some ticket. Okay, so almost done. This needs a little bit of attention here, just so that. Okay, so let me look at it. Actually, yeah, I'm not going to glaze over the street. I think this is good at this, because when I'm looking at actually what you are seeing is that the road is actually quite light compared to everything else. So I think this is good enough. Yeah, the only thing I'm kind of debating right now is if I should darken this. Feels a little bit bright. Okay, yeah. Let me do a glaze on top of that. Adding a little bit red to it too. Yeah, just so that this doesn't really jump out. It should kind of sit back a little bit. Okay, the window shouldn't be as bright, so that too. Okay, yeah, I think that's a good move. That pops out the light even more, and then it also just push this back just a little bit more so it doesn't jump out as a sore eye. Okay, I think red tails on the car. This? No, I'm just, this is not on, so car's not on, so we don't need to paint that. Yeah, this is some weird light areas. Just gonna paint those in. Just a couple darks that. Okay. So, the last thing that I'm going to do for this painting is to sign it so they know it's me. Let me move this paper a little bit to the right. So, I will sign my name on it, Eric Lin. What day is today? Today is May 24th, 2020. Okay. All right. So, yeah, Yeah, I'm just gonna leave it this one as is. I mean, I don't think we need a lot more detail. This is just kind of like a framing device. We want to kind of keep the viewer's eye more on this part, which is just the light hitting the house. And the figures here are mostly just for scale reference too, because we kind of want to feel a little bit more relatable. When you put figures in, is they're pretty good scale reference. There's a little bit too much white here, so I'm just gonna add a little bit of dark here. Yeah, but okay, and I'm just gonna soften this edge a little bit. Okay, yeah, that's enough. I'm gonna stop working on this. Okay, so hopefully this is fun to watch and helpful for you guys. Yeah, again, I wasn't planning to do a live stream this weekend, but kind of miss you guys, and at the same time, I think this is very kind of stress-free little paintings. Actually, it turns out quite nice. I'm gonna find out what paper is this, because I actually enjoy using this paper quite a bit. But and I think it's Fabriano, like 50% cotton, which is even more interesting because I've only been using 100% cotton, because I think 100% cotton consider more like professional. So I don't know. It's like just the paper feels really good, and the color come out very vibrant. I really like it. Okay, so like the color is really nice in this one, and it's really nice in the portrait too. Oops, my stupid head blocking the way. Yeah, like it really come out very, very nicely. Like all the vibrancy is there. So I think this is a very nice paper. I'm gonna try to find out what paper it is. Okay, sorry, I haven't been reading the comment that much. Hope you guys are doing okay. Lighter at the top. Not sure. Would you pull the paper underneath? Oh, yeah, I already did. Yeah, because I yes, at some time the paper was buckling like this, and I don't want to ruin by painting underneath here. So yeah, so again, I'll just flip through it again. That's a very cute whale. I think the sketchbook is probably handmade too, which is pretty nice. So that's their Instagram. So she's from St. Petersburg. So that's from Russia. And UFA, I am not quite sure where that is. I'm sorry, Rita. Okay, Alina from Victoria, Canada, and me, Redmond, Washington. Look at my ugly handwriting. Okay, so I'm just flip through that book again. That's from the first person. I'm really Svetlana. Yeah. Okay, not gonna sabotage the name again. So the first one and the second drawing from the same person. And then, yeah, this is a second person. I think it's from Rita. Quite nice. And that's Lilina from Victoria. So if you like their work, go follow them on Instagram. And that is mine. Kind of change of pace because I don't know how to use ink and pen and ink, and then doing transparent watercolor on top. And then, yeah, and then my portrait. So a little change of pace to have snug a portrait in it. Okay, so hopefully you guys enjoy that. I'll keep this video on the channel because I do think it turned out pretty well. Okay, if it wasn't, I'll probably take it out. But yeah, it ended up pretty well, so I'll keep it in the channel. I don't know. Next week, I will share a process of a portrait painting, which is right here. Where is it? Portrait painting I did 2 days ago. It's right here. Whoops. Okay, so I'm really happy with how this one turned out, so I'll share the process of it. And in the meanwhile, I will let you guys go. Have a wonderful rest of the Sunday. I will see you again next week.